right? We always want to start with what we're given, including the number, the unit, and what it is we're talking about. But before we start just converting, we want to think about what we're actually trying to solve for. So when we look at the question, it says determine the moles of ammonia. So we're trying, what we want to do is come up with that balanced chemical equation. The next step is to write what is given, and chemical equation gives us a mole relationship. The first thing I would have to do is convert what I'm given into mole using the relation. Now, the hydrogen, we have 2 times 3, giving us a total of 6 hydrogens. So we would need to put the coefficient of 3 in the stoichiometry problem, that we're not just keeping track of the number and units. We also want to make sure we're keeping track of what. Writing the formula for these ionic compounds is always the charge that determines the formula. Silver is plus. So when we're trying to predict our product, remember one of the ways to approach this is we take our, so your silver would replace the magnesium. So silver would now, because of this, the formula would be HeCl. So remember, always think about the charge when determining the formula. 2 nitrates to neutralize your magnesium. And any time you have more than one polyatomic ion, recall it, or the from which other one would be aqueous, which means it can dissolve in water. So when we look at our solubility rules, notice nitrates, it would be aqueous.